artists. How are you guys doing today? So we're home, and me as an artist, I really don't mind because I get to do all sorts of fun stuff. So I thought I'd put together a little video for you guys to keep you a little bit busy. And I also miss your faces so much. I miss saying, no running, please get back to your seat. Sit on your bottoms, please. So I hope you are sitting on your bottoms right now because we're about to do a fun collage. And I know it's silly, but I also miss listening to your kids' bop station. So I got my kids' bop right here, and I will put the sound on as soon as I tell you guys what we're gonna need. We are doing a collage with whatever you guys have at home today, okay? So markers, pencils, glue or glue, scissors, and a paintbrush for the blue, the glue, and watercolor paint, whatever you guys have. Like, this is not something that anybody's gonna go outside to buy anything. It's things that you have. We will need a newspaper, and then I'm sure mom and dad might have a piece of cardboard somewhere, so we're gonna cut this to whatever size we want. I'm gonna do like a little guy, maybe this much. And since it's already bent over here, I am going to just cut right there. We might need help from mom or dad or grandma, auntie, uncle, whoever is hanging around with you, because it's kind of hard to cut the cardboard. Right here, that's the piece I'm going to use, but we're not going to use this right now. We're going to color the newspaper. So open up to any page. I like it better when it's all just words. So you see how like this thing is right here. I'm going to cut a piece of this, and I am going to draw, paint, whatever it is. What we can do is, grab this. So I'm gonna cut out all the parts that have the black and white words on it because I wanna use this as a background thing, and then we're gonna draw on top of it. And then we're gonna cut and paste and glue and do whatever it is that we wanna do to it. Right, so that should be enough. Remember, we have a small space to fill, right? So if you want to know if you cut enough things or not, like if you just put this together like this, you know that you have enough, right? So that's pretty much good. So now I am going to put the music on, and we're going to play with coloring, and let's see what we can do, right? Ready? Apparently, my speakers are not ready. They had this all planned out. Okay, there we go. Start with my coloring pencil, and I'm just gonna make lines. You know, you could court, you could cooperate. There we go. All right. There we go. I like the markers better. They show up a little bit better. And you could do this any way you want. Like, you can draw on it, you can make a picture, you can do whatever you want. What I'm doing here is I'm making these lines one way, but I'm actually gonna cut it long ways. So I have little strips of all these colorful things to then glue it onto my cardboard. I need water. 1 second. And I forgot to mention, we'll need like a pink brush for the glue. I don't know if I said that or not. So this guy, let's see. I think I want to play with red. I think this I'm just going to make. My music is really not cooperating right now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just do the same color before I move on to another color, because that's how we keep our colors clean, right? So I'm gonna do that. In order to make sure that I'm not gonna color my colors with other colors, I'm just gonna wipe this down here before I move on to a different color. And if you guys wanna mix your own colors, I suggest that like you get the color that you want to mix and you do this, and then over here, or like anywhere on, you know, maybe a anything that you have that can be mixed into colors, you can do that and grab your other color and mix it here. See, you mix it outside, so then you still have this little palette here, but your colors are still intact. Color here now. Oops. Dude, seriously, I don't know what's wrong with this music today. Hey! I think I'm gonna go with the yellow now. Let's put some really bright, fun colors there. I really like how this is coming out. I kind of like how that looks. What do you guys think? Isn't that cool? I want to see what you guys make. So you guys have to take a snap and then send it to the DM at Super Kickers, okay? And then we can post it and then we can share everything. All right. What else do I want to do? Let's do one more with these things. Okay, I'm going to do lots of yellow now. I really like the yellow. And remember not to make your brush too wet, because if you make your brush too wet, your paper is going to take a really long time to dry. So we kind of want this to like just lightly cover it, and then we can cut it, right? Because if we put too much water, then we're going to have to wait too long to actually put this into our paper. What do I want? How about orange? Should we do orange? I like the orange. Kind of reminds me of a sunset. Right? Like a beachy sunset. Alright, and I am happy with this. Now we are going to start applying it to here. So what I like to do personally is just cut all of the pieces beforehand and then apply them. So I'm gonna figure out how I want to cut these. For example, for these guys, I know that I did it like this, and then I kinda wanna make straight lines going this way. And I like to prepare all of my material first before I start gluing, right? Same way that you guys do your, when you guys do that thing that you have to cut out all the words to make it into a sentence, it's kind of the same way. You have to figure out where your things are gonna go before you start gluing them, right? So I just want to cut all of these in this shape. We got water in this. We're not going to use that. Okay, so this is it. This guy's still a little bit wet, so I'm just gonna use my hair blow dryer. Maybe you might want mommy, daddy, grandma, auntie, uncle, babysitter, whoever it is, to kind of help you. And just want to do that lightly. Remember what I said about too much water? I put way too much water on this one, so this one's going to take a little bit longer to dry. We'll let this sit for a second. All right, so I think I want this to go that way. I want it long ways. Yes, long ways. So see, like this part is still a little bit wet. So be careful when you're cutting. Be gentle with it. Because otherwise you rip it and then you can't use it. Well, you could still use it even if you rip it. It'll be a little bit harder. Then we have our last piece of paper. Yeah, I like them all the long ways. You guys can cut it whichever way you want. It's not, this is, you guys know that I like to let your imagination run free. And so whatever you come up with, there's no right or wrong way in art. You do whatever your heart tells you to. There are techniques for certain things, but whatever you want to create, you should be able to create. I just mentioned, I'm going to teach you guys how to apply glue to a delicate piece of paper without being too much, right? Because you know that when we put too much glue on things, then it like gets all puffy and it takes forever to dry. So we are going to learn how to do it with a paintbrush, right? So I have my glue on a little cup. And what I'm gonna do is dip in there, and then you wipe it off. And then you wanna make sure that you're applying this with the paintbrush all the way down, right? So that's what you wanna do. So you see how the glue goes like transparent in there. So once you have that there, then you take your piece of cardboard and you glue it. And I think I'm gonna do mine in like a crisscross matter kind of thing. So you don't want to apply your glue on top of your cardboard. And the reason for that is that if you get glue on a place that you don't want glue to be, then your paper is gonna stick somewhere else besides where you put it, right? So you wanna apply it in a different place. Oops, see? It broke, but that's okay, because we can just glue it here. the best brush to do this would be like a flat brush, anything like that, only because you want it to kind of slide on the paper. The brushes that are like round or whatever, the one that I was just using, might be a little bit harder to apply it because it's not going to take as much space on the paper. But you always, if you guys have this glue at home, the stick glue, that works just fine too. Also, make sure that you're gluing the right side, right? Because I want this to show. So I got to make sure that I'm using the right side of it. So see like how this, like, that's the size that I want to use. That's the size that I want to glue. Although sometimes the design on the other side might be really cool too. So you might want to use that one. See why it's easier to just have everything cut and then you do it? Because then you, like, you can play around, you don't have to worry about it. Not like a checkered design kind of thing. I think that'll look cool. Let's do this guy on this side. My music is on again. Coming out super cool. I cannot wait to see what you guys come up with. And when using the glue stick, you guys don't have to press down really, really hard. Just like a light pass and it will work. Because when you press down really hard, all the glue squishes everywhere. And then you can't really reuse that glue. And like, there's like all that waste that goes on the side. So you see how mine is just really flat and there's like no glue coming off the sides of that. You see that? So you have to be gentle with your tools. You have to be careful with them. Learn how to like apply the proper pressure to the things that you want. Liking this. Thank you. So now, you see I glued over here, like it's, you could do that everywhere. Like you could have went sideways, you could have went whichever way you wanted. So now what I'm gonna do, because I have like these little things going on the side, I'm just gonna cut this off. Now, there's an extra step that I like to do. So I would suggest to grab, you know, something to put your art on top of it. And this is completely optional, but you guys know that I love to make a mess. So I am going to take the glue and actually spread over this. So when it dries, it's gonna have like a little shiny sheen to it, right? So, and you know, I love to get my hands dirty. So you kind of wanna be careful as you're spreading this over. Make sure that you're like following the lines and do it slowly. See, I just lifted that up. So, I love when glue gets stuck on my finger. And you want to do this mess on top of that little paper you put down, or like wherever it was that you're working, because if we like drop this everywhere, it's gonna be a pain on the bottom to fix it, to clean it up. Although baby wipes will clean glue and markers and everything off the surfaces, mom and dad. So if anything gets on surfaces when the kids are working, if it's like a formica top or something, you can just take the baby wipe and just wipe that right off. Also, when you're putting this coat of glue on, make sure that you're leaving it as leveled as possible, right? Because this does dry clear, but if you have puddles on it, it's gonna be like a little bumpy and it's gonna have like a different color. But that's it. That is it. I think we are done. And now we kind of have to let it dry, right? And then see what happens. So when my collage dries, I will post a picture. I'll send it to Super Kickers and then we'll post a picture. And then I really want to see what you guys made. And then so send us a picture and then we'll post it on our stories on Instagram. And then we can see what everyone's been creating. I hope you guys are okay. Make sure you wash your hands many times a day. Don't touch your face, don't pick your nose, don't pick your ears, and make sure that you're washing your hands for at least 20 seconds. If you don't know what 20 seconds is, sing happy birthday to you twice. That's usually what I do because I like singing happy birthday. All right, guys, have a wonderful day. Have fun creating. I hope that we can make lots of stuff together, and I will see you very, very soon. Mwah!